Starfish Space, a US-based satellite servicing company located in Tukwila, Washington, provides satellite servicing missions with its Otter servicing vehicle. The vehicle is designed to be used for life extension missions and end-of-life missions, such as deorbiting of low-Earth orbit satellites. The company was founded in 2019 and has raised over $50 million in venture capital funding. Starfish has launched one satellite so far, Otter Pup 1, in 2023. The mission quickly ran into problems, but was able to achieve some objectives, and lessons learned have been included in future versions. More on this first mission later in the video. Starfish has picked up interest from companies as well as the US government, with future servicing missions planned for NASA, the US Space Force and Intelsat. Starfish's vision is to specialize in satellite life extension and disposal missions first. Over time, they plan to expand their capabilities into in-space inspection, orbital relocation and logistics services. In addition, future servicing vehicles will be able to conduct repairs, component upgrades or in-space assembly and manufacturing. Starfish believe humans are meant to expand throughout the universe. Their novel technology will help build an autonomous off-world economy. Why Starfish? Starfish are known as the keystone species, meaning they are vital to their habitat and hold together the complex web of relationships in an ecosystem. They believe Starfish Space has a similar mission, to maintain and uplift the ecosystem of space, supporting its growth, health and long-term viability for human expansion. The Otter servicing vehicle. The Otter vehicle is at the core of Starfish's operations, designed for autonomy and versatility. Equipped with advanced guidance, navigation and control systems, it supports a range of missions, from extending satellite lifespans to responsibly disposing of decommissioned spacecraft. The vehicle's autonomous robotics enable precise and efficient operations in the challenging conditions of space. Okay, let's look at the technology Starfish is using on its autonomous vehicle. Technology. We can break down Starfish's technology behind the servicing vehicles into three critical areas. Let's look at each of them now. CETACEAN, navigation software. Starfish has developed their own vision-based navigation software that allows the vehicle to estimate position and orientation relative to the client's satellite. Their custom software integrates off-the-shelf sensors to provide all the required information for their guidance, navigation, and control system to maneuver around the client's satellite and even dock with it if required. CEPHALOPOD, guidance and control software. Sophisticated software is needed to safely approach and dock with a client satellite or perhaps uncooperative objects, such as debris or dead satellites. This software enables complex RPOD operations. RPOD stands for Remote Proximity Operations and Docking. It works with any spacecraft, whether it uses electric or chemical propulsion. Nautilus docking device. A critical part of the operation is the docking mechanism. This is the part of the servicing vehicle that latches onto the client satellite. The Nautilus docking device doesn't need prepared fixtures or surfaces on the client satellite. Otter Pup 2, the next spacecraft to launch from Starfish, uses an electrostatic attacher that can adhere to flat surfaces of various materials commonly found on satellites. Otter servicing vehicles can dock with any satellite, even those never designed for docking. Services offered by the Otter vehicle. Let's go over some of the missions the Otter servicing vehicle offers to clients. Satellite life extension. The Otter vehicle extends the operational life of satellites running low on fuel. By docking with a client satellite in orbit, the Otter acts like a jetpack, using its own propulsion system to maintain the satellite's position, allowing a longer lifespan, reducing or eliminating the need for a replacement satellite. Satellite disposal. To mitigate collision risks and free up valuable orbital slots, the Otter safely and reliably deorbits defunct satellites. This service ensures responsible management of space debris, contributing to a cleaner and safer orbital environment. In-space inspection, cooperative and uncooperative. The Otter conducts both cooperative and uncooperative inspections to diagnose satellite malfunctions or failures. For commercial operators, understanding the cause of a satellite's failure, potentially saving millions in future development costs, is invaluable. Additionally, military clients can leverage this capability to examine foreign satellites identifying their technologies or sensors. Orbital relocation. The Otter enables flexible orbital maneuvers, addressing the US Space Force's goal of maneuvering without regret. Unlike most satellites, which carry limited fuel for station keeping or minor debris avoidance, the Otter can relocate satellites to higher orbits. Repairs and component upgrades. The Hubble Space Telescope has been repaired and upgraded multiple times and continues to operate today, providing amazing photos of the cosmos decades after its original launch. Automated servicing, repair and upgrades ensure satellites can continue to provide critical data or services for commercial and scientific purposes. In-space assembly and manufacturing. Equipped with advanced robotic capabilities, the Otter supports in-space assembly and manufacturing. This service enables construction of large-scale structures, such as vehicles, space stations, or other facilities directly in orbit. By overcoming the size and volume constraints of launch vehicle payload fairings, in-space assembly unlocks limitless possibilities for building infrastructure in space. The Otter Pup 1 mission recap. Starfish Space's first mission, Otter Pup 1, aimed to test key technologies using a compact version of its Otter servicing vehicle. Before deployment, the space tug carrying Otter Pup malfunctioned, entering an uncontrollable spin. An emergency release deployed all payloads, including Otter Pup, which began tumbling at one rotation per second, far exceeding its design limit of 1 to 2 degrees per second. After months of innovative engineering, Starfish regained control, but the delay meant no client satellite was available for docking tests. Additionally, the onboard electric propulsion system, supplied by ExoTrail, failed due to an anomaly. While docking was no longer possible, a rendezvous operation remained possible. Starfish partnered with D-Orbit, whose ion vehicle had enough fuel after its main mission for the maneuver. The two spacecraft approached within 1 kilometer, allowing Otter Pup to capture images of the D-Orbit vehicle, achieving a partial success despite the mission's setbacks. The Otter Pup 2 mission. Starfish's Otter Pup 2 mission, set to launch no earlier than the 21st of June 2025 on SpaceX's Transporter 14 rideshare mission, marks the company's second flight of its servicing vehicle. The mission aims to demonstrate proximity operations and, if successful, dock with an unprepared commercial satellite in low Earth orbit, a D-Orbit ion vehicle. D-Orbit, a satellite integrator, deploys small satellites on rideshare missions like Transporter 14. Otter Pup 2 will attempt a more ambitious docking operation. Both spacecraft will launch together but drift hundreds of kilometers apart, allowing Starfish to test its full technology stack during a long-range rendezvous. Otter Pup 2 will use its Nautilus docking device to attach to a flat panel on the D-Orbit vehicle. The docking process, lasting a few minutes, involves maneuvering while connected before undocking and retreating. This mission will validate technologies for Starfish's future full-scale Otter vehicle. The mission is expected to finish off in the second half of 2025, depending on the speed of Otter Pup 2 rendezvous with the D-Orbit vehicle. NASA funds Starfish Space Debris Inspection Mission. NASA awarded a $15 million contract to Starfish Space to fund development of a debris inspection mission. The mission is called the Small Spacecraft Propulsion and Inspection Capability, or SPICE, scheduled for launch in late 2026. SPICE will use the company's Otter spacecraft to approach and inspect several US-owned defunct spacecraft in low Earth orbit using electric propulsion. The Otter vehicle will come within a few hundred meters of each spacecraft, observing its condition before moving on to the next object. Starfish Space said it has a list of potential objects that the SPICE mission will visit, but did not disclose them. The spacecraft will only approach these objects whose owners have granted permission for the inspections. In addition to the NASA contract, Starfish also received $37.5 million from the US Space Force for a contract to dock with and maneuver, while still connected, to a US military satellite. Starfish to service an Intelsat satellite in 2026. Starfish Space and Intelsat have signed a satellite servicing agreement set to redefine satellite operations. In 2026, Starfish will deploy its Otter servicing vehicle for its first commercial mission, extending the life of an operational Intelsat satellite in geostationary orbit. The mission consists of two phases. First, the Otter will maneuver to a retired Intelsat satellite in a geostationary graveyard orbit to demonstrate its docking capabilities. Next, it will dock with an active Intelsat satellite nearing the end of its operational life, using its onboard propulsion to boost the satellite's orbit and potentially add years to its service. This mission aims to kickstart a new market for on-orbit servicing, including life extension and satellite disposal. Starfish plans fleets of Otter vehicles providing on-demand services, leveraging core technologies like advanced manufacturing, robotics, and software for rapid scalable operations. For satellite operators, servicing vehicles could transform the economics of their industry, extending the life of multi-million or billion-dollar satellites designed for 20-year lifespans by even a few years offers financial benefits. Industry leaders are closely watching Starfish and similar startups as their technologies promise to reshape satellite operations. Upcoming events. Starfish Otter Pup 2 satellite is launching on the SpaceX Transporter 14 mission. The launch date is no earlier than the 21st of June 2025. SPICY, the NASA mission, the US Space Force mission, and the commercial Intelsat mission are all scheduled for launch in 2026. Do you think Starfish Space will be the first startup to demonstrate on-orbit servicing? Or do you think other startups like Astroscale will beat them? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.